3D bioprinting of Hep G2 cells and construction of a liver on a chip system for screening of hepatotoxic substances. In pharmaceutical industry, the characterization of potential new drugs is the most time and resource consuming part in the process of establishing a new product. Currently, standard procedure includes the use of two-dimensional cell cultures of primary hepatocytes or cell lines. The problem with this approach, however, is that the microenvironment of the 2D model on polystyrene is hardly comparable to the microenvironment in vivo, for example due to the difference in elasticity and presence of adhesion sites. Therefore, we developed a test system including a 3D cell culture of cells with liver-specific properties to recreate a more physiologically accurate microenvironment. For the 3D culture, we embedded HepG2 liver carcinoma cells in alginate gelatin hydrogel beads. The liver on a chip system consisted of two chambers that were connected in a continuous fluidic system. The beads were placed in the first chamber of the chip. The second chamber was intended to hold another cell type in order to investigate possible toxic effects of the drug candidate and its metabolites. For the bioprinting process, we first fabricated the hydrogels, which served as the matrix for the HepG2 cells. Since alginate is known to poorly promote adhesion of cells, which is important for the survival and proliferation, we also added gelatin to introduce adhesion sites. For the printing process, we set up a syringe pump system in an ethanol-sterilized laminar flow cabinet. To guarantee a sterile environment, we then positioned an UV lamp in the cabinet for 30 minutes. The hydrogel was then transferred into a 50 ml syringe and attached in the pump system with a 0.4 blunt end lure-locked fixed cannula. A calcium chloride solution was used for the polymerization of the hydrogel. In this process, the alginate and the calcium ions formed complexes, resulting in reversible cross-linking and consequently led to the mechanically stable bead. After 15 minutes, the beads were washed with PBS and stored in cell culture medium. A microsquisher was used for the determination of the elasticity modules of the differently composed beads. We also measured the dimensions of the beads. For the fabrication of the chip prototype, we used a stereolithography 3D printer Form 2 for the bottom of the chip. The cannulas and the cell strainer were inserted and fixed with dental glue. The beads were then placed inside the first chamber, a PDMS lid was attached and the chip was connected to a pump, ensuring a continuous flow of medium. Further experiments, such as proliferation assays of the 3D culture and toxicity studies on the chip, are necessary to evaluate the suitability of the system as an enhancement to the current 2D in vitro cytotoxicity assays. In order to establish our process on larger scale, a transfer to an automated 3D bioprinting system would be necessary.